Mohamed Ould Slahi est un citoyen mauritanien qui a été arrêté au lendemain du 11 septembre, suspecté d'avoir été l'organisateur des attentats du 11 septembre. Il aura passé 14 ans de sa vie enfermé à Guantanamo, sans charge contre lui.
People get to write a book? How many people get to write a best-selling book? How many people get to get their books adapted to a movie and with A-list actors? It's all like, I don't know. I'm very thankful, very grateful. My family was very poor. When I tell you very poor, not French standards, I'm telling you African standards. That is, my family did not have money to buy me shoes. I used to go to school without shoes. So blessed in that, you know, when I finished high school, I had this scholarship from Germany.
His family hoped he would go to Europe and he would learn engineering and be able to support them. And he did that. So he went to school, he learned, and in the early 1990s, about 1990, 1991, like a lot of young Arab men, Mohammadi went to Afghanistan to fight against the Soviet-backed communist government, which was at that time prohibiting the practice of religion in Afghanistan. He went for training there at an Al-Qaeda camp.
Is the most important person, it turns out, not in a positive way, in a negative way, and they always treat me the very last person. When you are inside the cell, they take everything. They decide what you eat, they decide what you drink, they decide when you wake up, they decide when to move you. They can move you at 3 o'clock in the morning. That's, you know, as it is bad enough. It's torturous. Add to that, when you're being sexually assaulted, if you are in shackles, in chains, you cannot defend yourself. This is very horrible stuff. And I can even say that it's even more horrible like for men. At least I can say it was very horrible. You know, it's not about sexual pleasure. It's about humiliation, you know, and beating. And sleep deprivation. You know, you cannot sleep. The first 70 days, straight, no sleep. 24-hour interrogation.
Qui agaçait beaucoup Mohamedou, et il avait beaucoup de mal avec ça, c'est que pour elle, l'important, c'était pas qu'il soit innocent ou pas, mais qu'il avait le droit à une défense. Et lui, il mourait d'envie de leur faire comprendre qu'il était innocent. Du coup, ils ont eu pas mal de conflits, et d'échanges un petit peu musclés, et jusqu'à ce que qu'il révèle un peu tout ce qui s'est passé, et ça a changé les choses.
I remember vividly when the book came out, you know, I was at one of the detainees class and it was Spanish. And, you know, I just went to the class to fit in because I want to be a good detainee. And there was like a TV channel playing Russia Today. And the headline, the first headline was my picture with the book. And I'm not a spoiled person. I'm not used at my picture on TV with good stuff being said. I felt like I'm a free person. I didn't care about anything anymore.
Il sort de Guantanamo, il sort de prison. Il sort d'une prison concrète pour se retrouver dans une prison à ciel ouvert, en Mauritanie, bloqué. C'est-à-dire que son passeport avait été récupéré par les autorités mauritaniennes. Il n'avait pas le droit de voyager. Encore actuellement, quand il essaie d'avoir un visa dans un pays européen, notamment l'Allemagne, où vit sa femme et son enfant, sa femme qui est avocate américaine, il n'obtient pas de visa. Il n'a certainement pas la notoriété des deux héros que je vais citer, mais il est fait du même bois. Ils ont la même grandeur et la même sagesse. Pour moi, c'est un mélange entre Mohamed Ali et Nelson Mandela.